A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 4th Feb, on the front page you have Supreme Court to frame issues for 9-judge bench hearing religious rights. So the CJI has acknowledged objection to wider review post Sabrimala and that it is a formidable point. So he says that you have raised possibly formidable points. We will hear the objections raised on whether the Supreme Court could have referred to a larger bench new issues on essential religious practices while deciding the Sabrimala review. So this is what Fali Nariman's senior advocate says, that there are at least 6 judgments of Supreme Court that say that while deciding review, Supreme Court cannot refer issues to larger bench. And another senior advocate, Shyam Devan, says reference to a larger bench in a review judgment is not permissible. If reference has to be made, it should have been done in the Sabrimala case before the final judgment on September 28, 2018. So Sabrimala case already decided. In a review, you cannot refer the case to a larger bench. And here you have N coronavirus outbreak declared a state calamity in Kerala. So now third case has been confirmed in Kasaragod in Kerala. 84 are under treatment. So state calamity has been declared in Kerala for new coronavirus. Then on page 7 you have Assam river on fire after crude spillage. So this is river in Dibrugarh district in Assam. It is called Burhidihi. So a stretch of this river in eastern Assam burned for 2 days because of spillage of crude oil from punctured pipelines. So the oil spilled and it caught fire. Oil India Limited officials say that if it would not have caught fire, then the oil could have been recovered. Then next is swarm of locusts spotted in border villages of Punjab. So these are locusts which come from Pakistan. Swarm of pests, and they travel into India, they enter into India through Punjab and they affect the crops. So timely action should ensure the elimination of these locusts before crops are damaged. So now, you know, steps have been taken to ensure that no harm comes to the crops. India has not witnessed full-blown locust cycles after 1962. But 1970 and 1993 were 2 years in which large-scale upsurges were observed. So locust breeding is a concern. On page 8 you have Nimhans to help ITBP staff beat stress. So this is National Institute of Mental Health and Neurosciences, which is now training ITBP, Indo-Tibetan Border Police staff, in combating stress and other psychological issues. So they reached out to those working in Dantewada in Chhattisgarh, which is a Nixal affected region, and also in Masuri to assess their needs. On page 9 you have most missing women from Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh. So the highest number of women and children who go missing in the country are from these two states, according to the study by National Crime Records Bureau. So the states record even highest number of missing children and women cases for 2016, 17 and 18. Then below you have, if tap water meets BIS norms, RO systems will be banned. So the Union Environment Ministry has published a draft notification that effectively prohibits users from installing membrane-based water purification, that is mainly reverse osmosis systems, in their homes if the water has been sourced from a supplier that meets the BIS drinking water norms. So installation of these will be prohibited at the point of use or at the point of entry for purification. And so again means even if the water is pure and people need to be assured and there is an RO system installed, it would not be allowed. So this is what has been stated. So RO, reverse osmosis, it is useful in reducing salts, but it does not tackle bacteria agents or trace chemicals, and manufacturers often claim that additional vibration is required to deliver potable water. So RO systems are not completely effective. NGT had ordered a ban on RO filters on the ground that they wasted water and that in the process of removing salts, they often deprive drinking water of essential salts. So the Ministry of Environment has published a draft notification to that effect. So BIS regulations for potable water is given here, you can see. That is 500 milligram per liter, you know, and 1200 milligram per liter of total dissolved salts, which consists of salts and some organic matter, are acceptable as such. So this is what is acceptable of the, you know, dissolved salts. Means 500 milligram dissolved salts of total 1200 milligram of organic matter. Of dissolved solids. So, so this is the detail of Bureau of Indian Standards regulation. So this is total dissolved solids. So desirable is 500 milligram per liter. Permissible is up to 2000 milligram per liter. So that is total dissolved solids. So total dissolved solids means salts and other organic matter. Then below you have Enforcement Directorate attaches assets in Rose Valley scam. So Enforcement Directorate has attached assets worth 70.11 crores, including bank accounts of multiple resorts, St. Xavier's College, Kolkata, and even Knight Rider Sports Private Limited in connection with the Rose Valley Ponzi scam. So total attachment in this scam stands at 4,750 crores. So it is alleged that the company Rose Valley collected fraudulently, you know, amount deposits worth more than 17,520 crores from public with the intention to cheat them and falsely, you know, promising high returns on investments. So out of the 17,520 crores, 10,850 crores was paid, but the remaining 7,520 crores, you can say around 6,000 crores something, is still to be paid back, and you can see already 4,750 crores worth of assets have been attached. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Camel in the Tent. So this is regarding government's proposal to allow district hospitals to be attached to private medical colleges. So this is a proposal which was given by Niti Aayog first, and it says that states should allow the facilities of the district hospitals to be available to medical colleges. It says the shortage of doctors which we have in the country can be taken care of through this. And it says central and state governments do not have sufficient fund as such resources and finances to bridge the gaps in medical education. So it calls for public-private partnership, bringing in private sector in medical sector. So this is been warned against, that this is like bringing the camel in the tent. This is what this editorial says. It says Tamil Nadu and other states which have robust healthcare system, they are, and they have a medical college in every district, they do not want their medical services, that, you know, how they operate and maintain the healthcare services in their state, to be affected by this plan of the center. And this is regarding sports, regarding Australian Open in tennis. The men's champion was Novak Djokovic, and in women it was young 21-year-old, you can see her name is American, Sophia Kenin. She is 21 and she is the youngest Australian Open champion since Maria Sharapova in 2008. Then the lead article is Towards Cooperative Federalism. So this talks about how not every state union disagreement is the same, and union must develop newer conventions to foster cooperation. So states can disagree, that does not mean they cannot cooperate. So, like some states like Kerala, West Bengal have raised issues on protests against NRC and CA. So resolutions have been passed by them. So that is also pointed out here. And this is what Brexit means for EU and its partners. So Brexit has taken place on 31st Jan 2020. Britain has exited, first country to exit from European Union. So it says it does not affect the core of the European Union. The EU project will be taken forward by the remaining 27 member states. So this is what is being spoken of in this article. Then on the OPED page, you have this coverage on non-violence. So it says a non-violent imagination ought to be ought to see means should see beyond militaristic nationalism and religious fundamentalism. So non-violence as an art of resistance, which Gandhiji propagated, is spoken of here. On page 13, you have here Operation Manila brings islands closer. So this is regarding Indian Navy's help to Madagascar. So Madagascar Defense Minister had visited India, and India's flood relief mission has been sent to Madagascar. And you can see this is first such high-level trip since Delhi incorporated the island off the coast of Africa into Indian Ocean region. So, Operation Manila has been initiated for Madagascar by India. So, and here you have Siachen troops given poor care, says CAG. So, Comptroller and Auditor General of India has given its report, which faults clothing and equipments given to troops at Siachen, which is the highest battlefield in the world, and in inhospitable climate. Then on international page, you have the same coverage on elections in USA. So Democrats and Republicans would be having their candidates standing, and in each state voting takes place. So that's the entire process of US presidential election. So that keeps coming in news. You can skip it. And this is regarding Trump's impeachment too, which keeps coming in news. So we'll not follow it on a daily basis. And this is regarding Britain-EU talks. Again, so far, no concrete steps have been taken. There are differences. Here, this is important news. This is China says it urgently needs protective suits and masks, and it blames the US for panic and not doing enough to help. So, shortcomings which China has highlighted in its visa response is that it wants more suits, more masks. So, it has given its list. On business page, you have manufacturing activity reaches a near 8-year high in January. So, country's manufacturing sector activity climbed to a near 8-year high, driven by sharp rise in new business orders amid a rebound in demand conditions that led to rise in production and hiring activity too. So, this is what this monthly private sector survey IHS Market says, which is now manufacturing activities at an 8-year high. So this is percentage growth. So it had been, the base effect will be there because the base, it had been quite low. The manufacturing sector was significantly affected amongst the three sectors, agriculture, manufacturing and services. So you can see now it has bound up. And below you have taxing investors on dividends will hurt REIT InvIT funding. So this is regarding real estate investment trust, and this is infrastructure, no, investment. So this the proposal which is there in the budget is to tax dividends in the hands of the investor. So those who are investing in REIT and InvIT will be affected because of this. So that is highlighted here. It says move will dampen sentiment of foreign investors. And this is with few takers of SSRC, RBI pushes deadline. So RBI had proposed this specialized supervisory and regulatory cadre, SSRC, but now it has been forced to extend the deadline by 6 months. It was to come into effect on earlier, but now it will be coming into effect, SSRC, on November 1, 2020. So it had invited application, RBI had invited application from its staff from grade B to grade F to apply for the specialized cadre, but response has been lackluster, and this is because of lack of any incentive as such for the staff to apply. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.